Hey guys, the dude from Denmark here. Welcome to episode 2 of Commander 13, the new Commander expansion that's about to come out from Magic the Gathering. A few spoilers have been shown today, so let's check them out. Card I want to show you today is called Primal Vigor, which is a green enchantment that costs you 5 mana to cast. If one or more tokens would be put onto the battlefield twice, that many of those tokens are put onto the battlefield instead. If one or more 1-1 counters would be placed on a creature twice, that many 1-1 counters are placed on that creature instead. Oh look, they made a reprint of Doubling Season, and even I wouldn't say it's a better one, because apparently this one is affecting the whole board, which I really don't like at all. It's really dangerous for you to put out, but in a multiplayer game it could be really good. But actually, if you read today's article on the MagicTheGathering.com, you will find that the reason that they reprinted Doubling Season with a new model. It's partly because of the doubling of planeswalkers loyalty counters and what they can do and so on. So if you read it, you will also see that the doubling season came out before planeswalkers came out, and it's an actually really interesting reading. But yeah, apparently this got reprinted and turned out to be this one because of the planeswalker effects that you could double, which were really too dangerous to do. So I guess that's fair, but I wouldn't play this at all. Last card I want to show today is called Eye of Doom, which is an artifact that costs you 4 mana to cast. When Eye of Doom enters the battlefield, each player chooses a non-land permanent and puts a fate counter on it. You can pay 2 colorless mana and tap this artifact to sacrifice it, destroy each permanent with a fate counter. There are a few interesting things with this card. One of them is that since everyone on the board chooses an online permanent to put a fate counter on, it's really not that great for you, since your stuff will also get destroyed. But the interesting thing is that you can choose when you want to do it. So you really have you kind of have the upper hand, I think, which seems really fun that the opponent never know when you will do this. So that seems really fun. Another thing is that in Theros we just had a card that also does this fate counter, the Triad, which in this case it seems like you can use it, which means that you can with this one you can put a fate counter on the target creature you want to, or other things, since it's an online, of course. But you can use this to put a counter on an online permanent on an opponent stuff, and then use the Triad to destroy it this way without you getting hurt at all. This seems really fun and really interesting, and it seems like a card that should have been in Theros, but I don't know why it wasn't. But I think it's an interesting card to play around with. So cards I wanted to show today. You can leave me a comment down below and tell me which commander you think are the most exciting ones and the cards we have seen for Commander so far. You can subscribe to me if you want. I will put new videos out whenever there are new spoilers for Commanders. So if you're interested in this, you can subscribe. Until next time, have fun guys.